Hello guys, today in this video I am going to show you how to install Confluence on CentOS core version. This is my CentOS 7 and the version is core, so there is no GUI, just command lines. In second step, I am going to configure this Confluence server on HTTPS, and third step is redirect all URLs to HTTPS. So let's start. For now, I am going to connect through the PuTTY with SSH session. So this is my PuTTY which is already connected. First of all, sudo yum update. Provide your super user password. Total download size is this one, and is this okay? Yes, hit enter. Is this okay? Yes, this one is also okay. Update is finished. I'm going to clear this one. Okay, that's fine. Now I'm going to install Java. So sudo yum install Java 1.8.0 OpenJDK. Hit enter. Provide your super user password. Total download file size is this one, and is this okay? Yes. Java 1.8.0 OpenJDK installation is complete. Check Java version. Or first, I will clear this one. Java version. Yeah, this is OpenJDK. Now I am going to check Java home environment variable. Echo $ Java underscore home. There is nothing because of I haven't set any Java home environment variable here. For that, I'm going to install nano. Sudo yum install nano. Yes, complete. Clear this one. That's fine. Now we need to find out Java installation directory. For that, update alternatives config Java, and directory is this one. So I'm going to set this directory as Java home. So sudo nano etc dot bash underscore profile. Hit enter and add here one line. Export Java home equal to this path. Yes, this path. Write out. Enter and exit. Now we need to reload bash underscore profile. So source etc dot bash underscore profile. Hit enter. It is reloaded. Now check again Java home. Echo dollar sign Java underscore home. Yeah, now Java home environment variable is set. Now we have to download Confluence file. So download Confluence for Linux. Download Confluence server. And I will download tar.gz file. Get started. That's fine. And download is started. I'm going to pause this one. This is the download link. Copy link address. For downloading, we need to install wget. So sudo yum install wget. Hit enter. Provide your super user password. Yeah, the file size is this one. And is this okay? Yes, this is okay. And it says complete. That's good. So wget and first I'm going to clear here wget and this is the download link and hit enter. Now it is downloading. It will take few minutes depending on your internet connection and file size. Confluence 6.15 download is complete. I'm going to create two new directory, one for Confluence and another for Confluence home. So sudo mkdir makedirectory. I'm going to create inside opt directory. So opt Confluence and Confluence home. Cd opt list. Yeah, there is two directory created. Returning back to root folder. In this step, I'm going to extract this Confluence compressed file. This file is in my root directory, home directory here. So tar xzf Atlassian Confluence with this version with .tr.gz. Hit enter. Okay, it says extracted list. Yeah, there is. So I'm going to insert this folder, change directory to this extracted folder. Enter. Sudo move mv strict all folders opt Confluence. Enter. Yeah, it is moved. Let's check. Yes, all files and folders are moved to the Confluence folder. So returning back root directory. Enter. In this step we need to check Confluence port. So sudo nano confluence configuration conf server.exml. Hit enter. This is the port. So default port is 8090. I'm going to use default port. If you want to change different port than default port, you can change here, but I will continue with default port. So exit. Now we have to configure Confluence home. So sudo nano opt Confluence web.inf classes confluence init.properties. Hit enter and here uncomment this line and my confluence home is opt/confluence/home. Write out or save, exit. That's good. In this step I'm going to start Confluence service. Sudo opt confluence bin start confluence.ess. Hit enter and it says Tomcat is started and no further action is required. Let's try to browse Confluence. Port is default port 8090. That's good. Okay, the site can be reached. I think CentOS firewall is blocking this port. I'm going to create firewall rule.